Hey, you. Yo, it's your boy Free. We here at the Savage Kitchen tailgate party.
And you know what the bend does? So what the bend does was when you put the card in the middle like this,
yeah,
you can actually see it very clearly,
yeah,
right? So look, here's what we're gonna do. I want you to snap again with your on the count of three.
Okay.
On the count of three, ready?
Uh-huh.
But with your card in the middle, bend somewhere, right there. Yeah?
Right there, I see it.
Right there. I want you to one more time, snap your fingers for me. On the count of three. 1, 2, 3, snap. It's like, you see a jump? You see a jump?
I did not see that jump. I don't know how I get from the middle to the top. It's my card, you guys.
This man is a magician.
Yo, you literally, like, you tried to show me that I'm supposed to see that what happened, and I couldn't even see it. That's the excitement. That was amazing. Wow. Woo!
No bullies, step back. Oh, sit and sit.
Back with Our Society TV. I'm Jordan Riley, and your name is, we know you,
Brianni Walker.
And you're just getting here. How you doing? Genesis, correct?
Yes.
Okay. And I hear that you're an ambassador.
Yes, I am.
And you are going to be presented with an award, correct?
Yes, I will be.
So how you feeling to be here today?
I'm really grateful, and I'm super excited.
That's right. That's right. So tell us about your journey and what have you been doing out there to help the people in your community?
Well, I mean, I have a company called Not for Dribble Kids, and I've been doing one-on-one private lessons where I teach kids about digital art, Web3, and meditation, and yeah.
Meditation. So you teaching people meditation? That's good. That's good, and we need that. So, you know, how the NFL is talking about ending racism, and we're here to talk about stop bullying. Do you believe that meditation can help people get over bullying or maybe stop being a bully?
Yes, I believe that can help them to take care of their minds. So, yes, that would be able to work.
So can you give me, like, a quick example of what type of meditations that you teach people to do?
Well, we say affirmations, so like we say things like, I am great, I am powerful, I can do anything I put my mind to, and stuff like that.
I am great, I am powerful, I can do anything I put my mind to. I feel better already. You got it. Where's the offering plate? I got to bless you. Yeah, so do you do that like every day, every other day? What's your routine?
I usually do it daily when I wake up or go to sleep, or whenever I get frustrated.
Now, how do you feel about that? Do you ever do some affirmations?
Oh, not really. Well, actually, yes, I do affirmations. I'm a part of Ladylike. Mm-hmm. It's with a whole bunch of girls, and they always tell us that we're beautiful, we're strong, and we can stand up for ourselves. It teaches, like, Miss Leah Pump, she teaches us how to become ladies and how to hold ourselves in the world, which I think is amazing. So we do affirmations.
Yes. So how do you see yourself impacting your generation? What would you like to see change as you're becoming an older person and walking into adulthood?
Well, I want to see all of us come together to create something great for our future generations, because I want change. I want our future generations to be free and to be who they want to be.
That's right. Y'all better give it up for Genesis. Yes. How about you?
I just want our future to come together, you know, as a community and, you know, just build each other up and not break each other down.
Yeah. So starting right now, what would be an affirmation that you would like to say in this Super Bowl season?
I am mindful. Mm-hmm. I am gifted. I am abundant. I am enough.
That's right. Come on. I am abundant. I am gifted. And you said, I am enough. I like how you worded that. How about that? Can you give us an affirmation?
I'm blessed. I'm gifted. And I like that I am enough. Okay. Right. You got to stick with that. Okay.
That's right. That's right. I know. Isn't that awesome? So you're getting an award. So you're excited about that?
Yeah. I mean, it's the first award I've ever received, so I can't wait.
Okay. That's good. And you know what? I know you worked really hard. We're here with Brianna and Mr. Phil Westbrooks. How you feeling?
I'm feeling great. Yes. It's an honor and a pleasure to be here and supporting a great cause.
Yes, that's right. Now, we've been saying whose house? Brianna's house, right?
But this is really your
house. This your house. So whose house?
Bill's house.
Whose house?
Bill's house.
All right.
Our house now.
That's right. Our house. With a lot of good dressed people and a lot of good food. How you feeling about this award ceremony, and what really moved you to support this young lady and what she's doing?
I'm very happy about it. I'm proud to be a part of it. I'm inspired by Brianna and everything she's doing and Genesis, and I was fortunate enough to meet her through Allen Shay, and when I met her, he said, oh, wait till I introduce you to this young lady. You are going to be impressed and inspired, and I was. And so from that point forward, I said, I want to support whatever she's doing, and the same, you know, with Genesis. So it's been a great opportunity, and we brought all these wonderful people together, and that's what it's about to me, is to network, to make sure we are strategically, you know, working on this anti-bullying campaign, and making sure kids are safe out there, have an opportunity to really develop and grow into themselves, feeling comfortable and confident with who they are.
Yeah. That's right. That's right. So they're talking about ending racism, inspiring change. So in your personal life, have you ever dealt with any bullying or you know, any hard trials that you can let someone know that, hey, this is what I went through and this is how I overcame it?
Sure. Yeah, I think we've all experienced that at some point, you know, growing up. Other kids are always, you know, whether they're older kids or whatever, and you're the younger kid on the block, you know, you always experience that. At least I did when I was a kid. So, you know, it was just about having good support system with my family and good friends who would also stand up for me. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, teaching people that bullying is not acceptable.
Exactly.
That is not funny. It's not fun.
Yeah.
You know, there's nothing good about it. So that was my inspiration.
I am your host, Jordan Riley. Again, thank you and welcome here on this awesome and glorious day. I just want to share this message with you about what this is all about. Whose House with Briani Walker will seek out the next generation with the support of the NFL as the inspiration for change with its leadership involvement with local and underprivileged youth in foster care to encourage and ensure the future it becomes an anti-bullied environment. Briani Walker has undertaken a one-year campaign to raise awareness about bullying and provide resources and create a safe haven for youth to dream, engage, and create discussions, develop positive content, and be the voice for solutions to help mandate bullying as a federal statutory law.
Juan, you're on.
Well, thank you so much for this award. This is the first award I have ever received, and this means so much to me. I like the NFL for inspiring change to end racism. Yeah. So, I would like to share some words. Firstly, I'd like to thank God because He is great. He is the reason I am here today. I also would like to thank my parents, my mom because she's my right-hand woman, and my dad because he's my best friend and he's instilled in me a strong belief that I can do anything I put my mind to. I also would like to thank Briani, Mr. Phil, Uncle Allen, and all the amazing people that made this event come to life. This award represents a lot that I stand for, three things that I really am passionate about: art, basketball, and learning. Art is a part of who I am. Everything is art, and I've learned from teaching kids that art heals. That's why it's so important for kids to create safe spaces.
When I was younger, so much younger than today, I never needed anyone's help in any way. Now those days are gone, and I'm not so still sure. I've changed my mind, I've opened up the doors. Help me if you can, I'm free now.
Yes.
And I do my part.
Hamlin.